Speak in tongues, begin to worship him. Ministry,
hallelujah.
kosa mini mini kobauri makusa bakori bahase rikuni mikibaluza dalabazi elebe kunini mikibaluza bade baroko zidi mikibata akuni miku mashaderio sekeba. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Shout a big amen to that and wave your hands unto the Lord.
Oh, amen. Hallelujah, eh. Oh, hallelujah. Zekone kwa sono. Samu amunimu. Sane ene dadano. Nansembo ne kosa. Ensembo. Misu ya uwa hankia. Enfansha opoto. Enfansha obagu. Na umano susa. Missy Christo asafono, mumbo se maya yino, enyo nyame yo.
Oh, say I'm a Sudino. inaya. Ebo didi nyamia ebi amami me inaya.
Hey! raising their standard tonight? Hallelujah. What a wonderful worship. I hope that your heart is ready for what God has for us today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We have had a wonderful 2 days. You may be seated. Wonderful 2 days of our conference. And today is the third day. We are very, very excited about what God is bringing into the house today. We have a very special guest, and I know that your life will never be the same again. If you're seated here, you're in for a shock, you're in for a blessing, you're in for something that you have never thought of. Amen. Hallelujah. We will continue our service. We're going to play the excerpts. Are we going to have praise and worship passing to us today? If we don't have the choir, we'll just listen. We will play the excerpts of the conference for day two from the media team.
Of importance, our names are always buried. In other words, we live an average life. Every woman can be a certain woman, but it takes special qualities to be a great woman. May the Lord give you that special qualities.
And one thing I took with me yesterday was dare to be different.
We want to welcome you once again into the service. We bless the name of our Lord Jesus and God, our Father who is in heaven, the great sustainer and founder of this ministry. Hallelujah. Let's give a clap offering. Our God is the sustainer of this ministry, and he has blessed this ministry. We welcome you all into the service in the name of Jesus. On behalf of our founder and our presiding bishop of the distinguished ministry, Dr. Dominic Newlove Alote, hallelujah. And our premier lady, our lady reverend, pleasant lady reverend, our host lady reverend, the host of this convention and conference. Please, with a standing ovation, let's just give a clap offering to our mama, our beloved Mrs. Reverend Naomi Alote. Hallelujah. We celebrate you, mama. We celebrate you. You have fought a good fight and you are still holding on. Thank you. Thank you for your prayers and your support. Hallelujah. We thank you. Tonight, we are blessed to be in this conference. Our theme says, you are not alone. You are not alone. And I'd like to say something about it because it looks as if we have been talking, but this was a powerful revelation for Mama Naomi to bring this at this time to host this conference with this theme, "You Are Not Alone." Genesis 28, 16. He says that, "And Jacob awake from his sleep, and he said, surely the Lord is in this place, and I did not know it." He thought he was going to his uncle's house. He thought he was leaving because he was a supplanter. He was afraid, and he got to a place of rest. And as he put his head on a pillow, the heavens opened, and he saw angels ascending and descending. And he said to himself, "The Lord is in this place, and I did not know it." I want you to know, woman, if you're sitting here today, that any place that you are, that you have discomfort, is an opportunity for an encounter. Amen. Tonight, we have an opportunity for a great encounter with the Lord. Hallelujah. We're going to ask the ministration of Zion's Chosen this evening. And with a clap offering, let's receive Zion's Chosen. Hallelujah. So we're receiving the ministry of the dance of Dr. Megan tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Dr. Megan.
Kingdom is coming now.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Dr. Megan. What a wonderful performance. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Hallelujah. Living ladies. I want to hear your voice. Living ladies. Hallelujah. We're going to take our offering. And I'm going to call upon Miss Florence Baba to help us with our offering.
Amen. Living ladies. Oh, are you here? Living ladies. I want you to stand up. Living ladies! Wow, indeed we are raising the standard. Amen. We've been blessed from Wednesday, yesterday, and today too we are going to be blessed. Amen. Please, can you project Luke chapter 6, verse 38? It says, give and it will be given to you, good measure, pressed down, shaking together and running over, will be put into your bosom, with the same measure that you use, and it will be measured back to you. Amen. You are going to give an offering. Give a good offering. Amen. If you've been blessed from Wednesday, yesterday, and today, you are going to be blessed. I want you to give a very, very good offering. Amen. So we will call upon the living voices to give us a song and to take our offering. Amen. Please, those online, you know how we do it. Can you project it for us, please? Those online. The pale. Okay, this is the Ghana one. No, you want. We want the US one, the foreign one. Good. Okay. Amen. So please help us. Amen. Living voices, please, can you be.
We're going to ask Pastor Kofi to give us a song while we bring in the offering. Hallelujah. He was.
Give it up to Jesus. Put it together. Bless you, mommy. Bless you, daddy. Oh, you, mommy. Living ladies. I want you to tap your neighbor. Ask your neighbor. Take a look at me. Ask your neighbor. Can you see me well? Are you sure? Ask your neighbor. Can you see me well? Say to your neighbor, I'm walking in power. I'm walking in miracles. Your neighbor is still seated. Tap your neighbor. Are you still a living lady? Tap your neighbor. Ask your neighbor. Are you still a living lady? Are you sure? Look straight into her eyes. And say to her, I'm walking in power. Are you walking in miracles? I live a life of favor. Because I know who I am. Can you rise to your feet and take a step? I'm walking in power. Can you take a step? I'm walking in power. I'm walking in power. Take your step, take your step. I'm walking in miracles. I'm walking in miracles. I'm walking in miracles. I'm walking in miracles. I live a life of favor. Cause I know who I am. I'm walking in power. I'm walking in miracles. I live a life of favor. Cause I know who I am. Tap your neighbor. Take a look at me. I'm a wonder. It doesn't matter what you see now. See His glory. I know. Tap your neighbor. Take a look at me. I'm a wonder. It doesn't matter what you see now. See His glory. I know. Take a look at me. I'm a wonder. It doesn't matter what you see. Tap your neighbor. Say, see. There is glory all over. Tap your neighbor. Take a look at me. Take a look at me. Take a look at me. See His glory. Take a look, take a look, take a look. It doesn't matter what you see. See, see, see. Everybody shout, say. Oh, 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 oh. I know who I am. Everybody let your voice shout and say.
Hey,
let me hear your voice.
Together, church, come on, do it better than that. Hallelujah, amen. Take your seat for one moment. Take your seat for one moment. My son is here, you know, and I can't let him come and without ministering to us a song. Amen. The only one, Jack Alolomi. Amen. Let's welcome Jack tonight. Come on, let's welcome Jack tonight. Come on, give God a clap for my son.
Amen. 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 Kuni asa uye obi kase uji ona yedi obi kase asa atoba uye asi. Obi pejane sanon kase uji uji muna yende yedi yedi atafusu anajio asa ah obi tuwasiye obi tuwasiye obi pejane sanon kase uji uji muna yedi yedi. Alo tenya mi ti asio asa. Hey, 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 hey. Obi peja ni sana kase. Uji, uji mune, uji mune. Yeti, yeti yata fusu. Anaji asa. So badiadiba asa asa fuye anaji adia na miwo yema Christo media me bodidi namado anaji media dia pen na miwo. I give a pen me wo, yeah, my me,
Wonderful time of worship. Thank you. May God richly bless you. Thank you for honoring our invitation to come and sing. Before I call the next person to come on and sing, I want to introduce some honored guests that we have in our midst. tonight, starting from my right hand side. Give me a wave as I introduce you. The person who sang Bishop already introduced him is the son of Bishop, and I thank you for your wonderful ministration tonight. The one and only, God bless you, a favorite son of Bishop. Thank you. Then I want to introduce our next person, the person who ministered to us tonight, Dr. Megan. Wonderful ministration. Thank you. Your outfit, everything that you did is on point, and we thank you for coming. Thank you so much. We also want to honor another wonderful person who is in our midst, Dr. Mrs. Frida Intifu, with her team. You have been here since the beginning, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. You closed your church, like we said. Hallelujah. Thank you so much for being here. And then we also want to introduce Minister Kase Mate. Hallelujah. And she's going to give us a song. Bless us tonight. Hallelujah. Thank you. I just want to do one thing because it's a protocol. I don't want to break it. I also want to honor another wonderful lady, a daughter of Bishop, who is part of the house. But every time that we gather, I'm so glad among her busy schedule, she still makes time to be in the house. With a clap offering and with a wave from Honorable Dr. Hannah Bisu, we want to welcome you to the house one more time. Thank you so much that though you're busy, you always make time and you're here. God bless you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. It's an honor to be a blessing tonight. Hallelujah. I am not alone. I don't know about you, but I am not alone. Fill my cup, Lord. I lift it up, Lord. Come and quench this thirsting of my soul. Tonight, bread of heaven, fill me till I want no more. Tonight, fill my cup. Fill it up and make me whole. I can't go back the same. Fill my cup, Lord. Tonight I lift it up, Lord. Come and quench this thirsting of my soul. Bread of heaven, till I want no more. Fill my cup, fill it up, and make me whole. Bread of heaven, oh, tonight I am not living the same. Fill me till I want no more. Fill my cup, fill it up, and make me whole. Like the woman that bled for 12 years and touched the hem of Jesus, he said, "Mema wa tamfu esi won tri ase. Mema we hu kan kona wa sani wana chi. Afimo mama wo swati na hu. Nama shawe. Where who said,
we are left with 6 months. But the God who said there is 1,000 years and 1,000 years. Remember what time for us he wants to ask me. Remember when who come call, now I stand on the sea. I see ya. The lady that asked me to come be a blessing says I should sing an Ewe song before I leave. Jesus, I am talking about. I know the Jesus I am talking about. Yeah. Our Lord. Our Lord. So tonight he will do a new thing. As you serve you.
Yes, you can let me know what you're doing. As you serve you.
Administration. Let's be upstanding. We're going to quickly take our confession. Right after the confession, the media team will introduce our speaker for tonight. Hallelujah. Confessions for today. We need that faith confession. It's our capsule. We need to take it quickly. Thank you, Lord, that your word never fails. I therefore boldly declare. Go ahead with me. And in this year, I will conquer and prosper. I will dominate. I will rule. And I will serve in the power of the Holy Spirit. By your word, I am connected to the boundless resources in Christ that firms my belief that I will advance in my walk with God, in my family, in my relationships, in my finances, in my academics, in my profession, and in every area of my life. I will apply the word of God, which dwells richly in me, to accomplish everything I have set my heart to achieve this year. I will never be afraid because the Lord is with me. Premature death will never be my portion. My light will shine very bright to God's glory. I declare, this is my year of supernatural advancement. In Jesus' name, amen. We'll take our video introduction of our speaker tonight.
Reverend Mrs. Rita Korankye Ankrah is the First Lady of the Royal House Chapel International Church, which has over 200 branches and affiliate churches in Ghana, USA, and Europe. She's an alumnus of St. Mary's Secondary School in Ghana's national capital, Accra. She holds diplomas in business studies, counseling and psychology, and entrepreneurial studies. She also holds a bachelor's degree in business entrepreneurship and management from the Ghana Institute of Management and Public Administration, and a master's degree in governance and leadership from the same institution, winning the Best Student Award in 2006. After 10 years of working with Bank for Housing and Construction, Reverend Mrs. Korankye Ankrah joined her husband, the Apostle General Most Reverend Sam Korankye Ankrah, as a full-time minister of the gospel in 1981. She's the director of Social and Practical Ministry, which covers the men, women, young adults, teens and children's ministries, family life ministry, school of restoration, and all the humanitarian projects of the church. Mama Rita, as she is affectionately called, is founder of the Royal Ladies Ministries International and hosts the annual Shiloh Conference, which brings together women from all branches of the church, local and international, for a weekly time in God's presence, earning her the name Mama Shiloh. She is involved in philanthropic works, most especially to her alma mater, instituting the Sanctuaries Ankrah Award for Best Teaching and Non-Teaching Staff from February 2006 till date. In February 2017, under the Royal House Chapel Scholarship Scheme, she offered full scholarships to students of St. Mary's Senior High School from senior high school through to the university. Her yearly distribute needed items to orphanages across the country and also host the aged each Christmas season. Mama Rita is a regular speaker at the church's annual Week of the Altar program. Reverend Mrs. Rita and her husband, A.G. Sanctuaries Ankrah, are blessed with 4 children, 3 grandchildren and counting. Rema House, with a standing ovation and a warm shout of appreciation, let's welcome to the stage Reverend Mrs. Sanctuaries Ankrah.
Praise the Lord, church. I can't hear you. Praise the Lord, church. Bishop, I honor you. You are looking too handsome.
Hallelujah.
If Mama Naomi plays small, I'll get you a girlfriend. You will not play. Hey. Tell a lady by you, I will not play. My darling, tell the person, if you are joking in your marriage, me, I'm not joking. Tell the person, I have worked. I won't allow anybody to come and take my place and come and take my enjoyment. Now is my season for enjoyment. Now is my season for laughter. I will laugh. I will laugh. I will laugh. I will laugh. Mama Naomi, you know I love you. And you can't do anything about it. If loving you was a mistake, I don't want to be right. I love you. My message tonight is, it is my time to laugh.
Oh yeah, oh nyami bi, wufi, eja. Oh,
26 verses 1 to 3, we will read and then you have your seat. Psalm 126, reading from the New King James. When the Lord brought back the captivity of Zion, we were like those who dream. Then our mouth was filled with laughter and our tongue with singing. Somebody will sing tonight. Then they said among the nations, the Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things for us, and we will be glad, and we are glad. I see that tonight, God will turn your sorrow into joy and your tears to laughter. He will turn your sorrow into dancing. I don't know who walked into this room confused. I don't know who walked into this room crying. I don't know who walked into this room with an aching heart. I don't know who walked into this room sick. I don't know who walked into this room with bad news. I don't know who walked into this room confused. I am here to let you know that the Lord will turn your life around. I see you laughing. I see laughter. 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 I see laughter tonight.
Here are the new ingredients. I'm a man singing to be. Every set on me, on the waka. Obe Shiraye, Amale Shira. Missy Radio Union, Bededio. Amama, Senyine, Unabi. Every set on me, on the waka.
With you. You didn't hear me. I said those who laughed at you before you came here, before today, they were laughing at you. This time, after this conference, they will not laugh at you. They will laugh with you because I see dancing. I see dancing. I see dancing. I see dancing. It doesn't matter what you have gone through. It doesn't matter what you are going through. Your season of laughter is now. Your season of laughter is here. Your season of laughter has come. I see a turn around in your life. I see a turn around in your life. Your weeping has expired. Your pain has expired. Your sickness has expired. Your poverty has expired. Whatever you are going through, you shall not go through anymore. The pain shall not be there anymore. After this conference, after this conference, after this conference, I said after this conference, Living Ladies Ministries, you will turn around, you will look to the left, you will look to the right, You will look to the north. You will look to the south. You will look to the east. You will look to the west, looking for your problems, looking for your sorrow, looking for your sickness, looking for your difficulties, and you will not find them again.
The words you say, thanks things around your outstretched arms has lifted me. You took away the chains and cords that held me back. Onisha, Iyanu,
you're the God of
the God of us and wonders. Taste that of your power.
Onisha,
Onisha, Iyanu,
you
have shown me so much mercy. Much more than I deserve. The works you speak, thanks things around.
Your outstretched
arms
has lifted me.
You took away,
you took away
the chains and cords.
Please be seated. Royal ladies, give me a wave. Royal ladies, give me a wave. Royal ladies, give me a wave. I love you, Reverend Senna, everybody here. Thank you. Our members from Ashaley, Botwe, God bless you. And all the people I came here with. Living ladies, are you here? Now to the background story. Psalm 126 is a song that looks at the Jews and looks at when they returned to Jerusalem from their exile in Babylon. They were in Babylon for 7 years, 70 years in captivity. When we talk about captivity, captivity is a stage or a period of being held. It is a stage and a period of being in prison. It is a stage and a period of being enslaved or confined. According to the Cambridge Dictionary, captivity is the situation in which a person is kept somewhere and is not allowed to leave. I don't know if somebody is in captivity at this time. Where your family witches have kept you in captivity. When the principalities in your father's hometown and your mother's hometown have kept you bound. But I'm here to let you know that tonight they will let you go. I have too many unbelievers here. I said tonight they will let you go. Pharaoh tried for so long, not allowing the Egyptians in Egypt to go. But when their time came, tell somebody sitting by you that your time will come. Tell the person your time go come. My darling, when their time came, Pharaoh allowed them to go. The freedom of the Jews was forcibly or forcefully taken away from them. They had suffered so much, and then suddenly God turns their story around. Suddenly God turns their life around. Suddenly, there was a turning point in their life. Cyrus, a new king that arose in Persia, made an announcement allowing all the Jews to go home. My darling, before I came here, I heard the gossip. In the gossip, I heard an announcement. And the announcement is that it is time for your freedom. You are about to be set free from poverty. You are allowed to be set. You are allowed to now move and take a step. I see a chain around you that instead of moving forward, they are moving you backwards. But tonight, I break the chain. I break the chain. I break the chain. I break the chain. I see a monitoring device. And that monitoring device monitors your progress. That monitoring device tells where you are going. That monitoring device tells of your future. That monitoring device tells of your next level. They look at that monitoring device and they determine whether they must allow you to go or not. Tonight, whatever they are using to monitor you, I break it. 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 And I set you free. And I say, though you are alone, my darling, you are not alone. There are angels around you. There are principalities of God around you. There's Angel Michael, the warring angel. Angel Gabriel also around you. And tonight, everything they are using to monitor you, I break it now.
Oh, come unto me, Suro Bibi. Nyami Tufu. Yeah.
Was an announcement. The announcement was for their freedom. I want you to listen to me carefully. The announcement was for their freedom. But within the announcement, Cyrus said, "You are not going to go empty. I command your neighbors to give to you gold, to give to you silver, to you give to you diamonds. My darling, you are going to be set free. But in being set free, you won't go empty-handed. You are going to go with riches. You are going to go with marriage. You are going to go with children. You are going to go with prosperity. You are going to go with houses. You are going to go with cars. I see them coming. I see them coming. I see them coming. I see them coming. I see businesses coming to you. I declare you blessed. I declare you whole. I declare you successful. I declare that it shall be well with you.
Amiunti, Misurobi.
are waiting. What do you do whilst you are waiting? You are in your period of captivity. You are in your period of bondage. You are in the period of prison life. What do you do whilst you are waiting? I want to leave you with four words. What do you do whilst you are waiting? I leave you with four words. Number one, the past. Number two, the process. Number three, your prayers. And number four, your praise. Number one, the past. Number two, the process. Number three, your prayers. And number four, your praise. Number one, the past. Anytime you are in difficulties, is it possible to get a bit of light? Bishop, I'm not used to this clap cry. Can I have some more light? So I can see my audience. Whether I'm blessing them or not. And so that they can see my beauty very well. I spotted for Bishop and Mama Naomi. The past. Listen to me carefully. I don't want you to lose anything. Anytime you are going through pain, anytime you find yourself within the wilderness, anytime you realize that things are not moving well, look at what God has done in the past. Look at how God helped you in the past. Look at what he has already done in your life. According to the scripture we read, Psalm 1 and 2, when the Lord brought back the captivity of Zion, we were like those who dream. 1 and 2 is actually talking about the past. It's talking about how God helped them in the past. What has God done for you in the past? The same God who did it for you in the past will do it again. Your amen is suffering from anemia. I have Dr. Debbie here. What did God do for you in the past? I am here to let you know that the one who did it yesterday, he's about to do it for you today. And he will do it for you tomorrow. The fact that you are crying today doesn't mean that yesterday he didn't show up. Most often, we are quick to brood over our pain. Why me? Why is this happening to me? Why is it happening at this time of my life? Why have I been married for 10 years? And yet I do not have children. I am here to let you know that the God that brought the man, the God that calls you to be married, that God is not dead. That God hasn't traveled. That God is not sleeping. If he did it for you yesterday,
He will do it for you again. I said, if he did it for you yesterday, he will do it for you again. If he did it for you yesterday, he will do it for you today. If he did it for you yesterday, if he did it in the past, if he did it in the past, if he did it yesterday, if he did it 2 years ago, if he did it 10 years ago, I am here to announce to you that he will do it for you again.
You do not lie, you do not fail. What is not for you to do, it has in essence stone. It can never ever exist, though. You do not lie, you do not fail. What is hard for you to do, it doesn't exist, though. It can never ever exist, though. According to your knowledge and your will for me, what you said you have done, I just need to align, oh. Because you are not a man that changes your mind, oh. Those that know you will trust in you, not in horses and chariots. By the arm of flesh, no man can breathe it. What is hard? What is hard for you?
It can never exist.
It doesn't exist. It can never, ever, ever, ever exist.
Psalm 30 from verse 1. And this is David. David says, I will extol you, O Lord, for you have lifted me up and have not let my foes rejoice over me. O Lord my God, I cried out to you and you healed me. O Lord, you brought my soul up from the grave. You have kept me alive that I should not go down to the pit. What is actually happening here is that David remembers how God had successfully delivered him from troubles in the past. And he says, oh Lord, you have lifted me up, past tense. You brought me up from the grave, past tense. And you restored my life as I was going to the grave, past tense. Are your English teachers still alive? So you know past tense. You restored my life as I was going down the grave. David knew so well that when difficult times come, you must remember that the God that delivered you before, that same God will do it again. If you remember him as the God of the past, my darling, when the devil is working schemes in your life, you will relax. Because you will know he will do it again. Go ahead. During the COVID, I traveled to the UK. Whilst in the UK, one of my very good friends, I call my sister and everything, had lost her mom. So I decided, you know, in Ghana, you have to pay homage. So I had to go, as tradition demands, to pay homage and say hello to her and all that. When I was coming back, I felt very, very funny, very uneasy. That day I was fasting, so I thought it was the fasting. When I got back to my flat, Dr. Debbie, I couldn't breathe. I realized that I was losing my breath. And with me, anything that happens to me, headache, what? The first thing is to check my pressure. When I checked my pressure was 186.96. So I took medication. After 30 minutes, I felt like I was passing out. I checked my pressure again, and my pressure had gone to 198 over 100 and something. The doctors and nurses know. But for some reason, I was calm. Very, very calm. I was calm because 3 years prior to that, I had gone to the U.S. In the U.S., I felt very, very dizzy. Anytime I walked, I felt like the world was turning around me. As usual, I checked my pressure. My pressure was about 190 something over something. And I realized that it wasn't coming down. So Apostle General called the ambulance. My first time in the ambulance. In the ambulance, they checked my pressure again. And they realized the pressure kept going up. Now it moved beyond 200. So you doctors, you know, I'm sure they thought the veins in my brain had ruptured or something. So they kept doing their finger like this to check if my eyes will move according to their finger. Everything they did was negative. I was checked into the hospital. They did series of tests. Everything was negative. So that day in UK, when it happened, all I did was to remember the past. Remember the God in the past. The God that healed me in America. The God that never made me get a stroke. The God that never killed me. The God that made sure that my enemies didn't laugh. The God that made sure that those who have bought my coffin whilst I am alive, they went into the coffin and I am still alive. Somebody can't hear me. Mama Naomi, my enemies, who thought that after working, when I was in poverty, when I was in one room with my husband, when I didn't have a curtain, and I used my cover cloth as a curtain, when I was pregnant with my first daughter, who is now Reverend Nana Konquest Ankrah Ankrah, and I couldn't afford folic acid, B complex, while I delivered my baby and I didn't know how I was going to discharge myself, they want me to die, so they marry my husband. Go and tell them that I said their mothers and their fathers. My darling, listen.
the God that healed me the first, I knew that same God would do it again. My darling, if God has kept you from when you were crawling, from when you were sucking the breast of your mother, from when you entered into class one, from when you entered into secondary school, from when you entered into the university, the God that has kept you, Mama Naomi, and has protected your marriage, and has protected your children, and has protected your ministry, that same God will do it again. I don't know who I am talking to, but I have come to let you know that the God that has been with me, that same God will be with you.
See the way you love me. See the way you care for me. You carry my matter for your head, oh.
In a melody, in a song.
See the way you love me. See the way you care for me. You carry my matter for your head, oh. In a melody, in a song. Like a little baby, you watch over me, oh. You know they carry me, they play, oh, in a mail, oh, ah, 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 in a samo,
in a samo,
in a mail,
oh,
ah, ah, ah,
we will go back. Honorable, listen to me. The gods that was with you in the past, that God, mark my lips, is about to do something for you. That God will honor you one more time. That God will lift you one more time. That God will make you laugh one more time. That God will make you dance one more time. Shame and disgrace is not our portion. My darling, look at me. If you think you are going to die for somebody to enjoy what you have worked for, you will disappoint them. When I got here, Bishop said I was looking beautiful. Bishop, I am not done, no. I've told my husband, Mama Faith and Mama Naomi, listen, that he better not die. If he go and look for trouble and he dies from heaven, he will see me with some young guy.
Promotions everywhere,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
Contract everywhere,
yeah, yeah.
Plenty money everywhere, cause you the lead me every day. I like it, I like it, no. I like the way you the lead me, no. You made the little things I do, sir. You made the little things I do. I said I'll be thin, though. Your grace makes a difference. Just the embarrass. Everybody shout, I like it, ooh, to you. I like the way, I like the way you delete me, oh.
Please, your enemies are not looking at you. Show them that you are alive.
Jesus. My life, my life, my life, my life.
Dr. Champo, I honor you. I didn't see you. All the gurus and the owners of living word, living faith, I honor you. I salute you. The leaders of living faith ministries, I honor you. The leaders of living ladies, I honor you. Number two, the process. The process. Verse 3, 126:3. The Lord has done great things for me. The Lord has done great things for me. And we are glad. Know that difficult times don't last forever. Somebody didn't hear me. I said difficult times don't last forever. It is only a period in your life. It is only a process in your life. You see, verse 1 and 2 was actually talking about the past. But verse 3 is in the present. The Lord has done great things for me now. And I see that the Lord will do great things for you. We all go through a period of hard times. We all go through a period of pain. Just like I was talking about, I'm not a superhero. So once a while, when I don't sleep well and I am not resting well, my pressure will go up a bit. But my darling, it is not forever. Somebody didn't hear. Once a while, you will cry. We all go through a period of weeping. But I am here to let you know that whatever you are going through now, you go to bed in tears. You wake up in tears. And you wonder, is this how my life is going to be? Did God design my life to go through a period of struggle? Does God even care about me? Does God know what I am going through? Will I ever be happy again? The first year of my marriage was blissful. It was good. Second year was good. After the season of honeymoon, it's been crying and crying and crying and crying. I have come to announce to somebody that you will laugh again. Why don't I have a job? You will get a job soon. Why am I on the same level and not being promoted? You will be promoted very soon. Why am I not married? My darling, the man is coming. Why am I the one begging for food all the time? My darling, it shall not be long. Others will come to you for food. I see that your season of crying is season. You didn't hear me. Your season, S-E-A-S-O-N. Your season, your period, the process you are going through is about ending. Is season. S-C-E-A-S-I-N-G. Is season.
and your period of rest is coming. Who tells you you will beg forever? Who tells you you will be in debt forever? Who tells you you will be barren forever? Who tells you you will be single forever? Who tells you you will be crying forever?
Jesus,
I have come to let somebody know, weeping may endure for the night. Weeping may endure for the night. Waiting may endure for the night. But joy comes in the morning. Joy comes in the morning.
Obey Shiraye, Amaya Shira.
Solomon says, to everything there's a season. My darling, it is a season in your life. A time for every purpose under the heaven. A time to weep. And a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance. You must always remember, difficult times don't last forever. It is only a season. It is only a period. It is only a process in your life. This too shall pass. Even the MPP government knows this. It was their slogan. Akufo-Addo said, it shall pass. This too shall pass. When you are going through pain and you are going through sorrow, you sometimes wonder for how long. Psalm 126 says, you will laugh again. In God's time, your sorrow will be lifted, and God will fill your mouth with laughter and cause you to sing the latest gospel song. Bishop, I don't know if you've heard the story of Apostle General and I. We and all the fathers in the land, we came out of the 1983 hunger in Ghana. That season of our life, we all entered into a season of prayer, a season of evangelism, a season of bus-to-bus ministration, a season of market preaching. I mean, and after that season, God began to raise everyone, Mensor Tabel, all of them. Lighthouse, Victory Bible Church, all of us. They all started their ministries. The ministries were doing well. And we were pastoring a church. It wasn't our own church. We were pastoring a church. I don't know if I shared this story here before. We were pastoring a church called Living Word. Bishop, it doesn't matter how much we tried. The church grew to 30 congregations. Anytime the church was 35, five people would leave. When you got to 40, 10 people would leave. I hadn't seen a church like that before. And a church that the deacons were that powerful.
They control the resources, controlled everything in the church. The guitar will have a problem. If you go for money to repair the guitar, the head deacon will ask you, in other words, there's no problem with it. Out of frustration or frustrations, my husband sojourned to the Netherlands. That's how come he went to Holland. Within the 2 years that we were apart, my sister got married. Then I went to ICGC. They used to meet at Baden-Powell Memorial Hall. When I got there, Bishop, crowd be this. Those days, electric organ had come. Electric drums had come. When they hit one, you know how me, I don't joke with worship. I don't have the voice for it. But the spirit for worship, I have. They hit the drum. The organ. You don't need to have a voice to be a worship leader. People don't know that. When the crowd is there, oh my God, they raise one song and the whole place is electrified. I sat down in the auditorium. I said, God, you are not fair. I said, God, you like people and some people you don't like them. Some people, you call them Samuel, and others, you call them with a whistle. I said, God, all of us came out of 83. We were all doing evangelism. We were all preaching. We were all doing dumb broadcasts. We were all preaching on the buses. We were all doing all nights. How come you have blessed some people? My husband and I, tell me, God, what sin have we committed? That as for us, in pastoring a church, we have been called for 30. I said, God, if you have called me for 30 congregation, I don't like it. I said, God, me, I don't like where two or three are guarded. Where two or three are guarded, they know what you are eating in your house. They know what is happening in your bedroom. They know what is going on between you and your husband. They know everything. Big church. Nobody hears anything. I said, God, I don't want 30. Listen to me. And I am going to move to my third point. In that auditorium, you know, they do a brofosan. I didn't care who was looking for me, who was looking at me. They lifted up a song. I went on my knees. I was sitting in front, though, went on my knees. I realized that the knees, God wasn't seeing it well. So I laid prostrate before God. People were looking at me, I didn't care. I said, God, do something for my husband and I. After then, he began to call me. What do you want? What should I send you? I said, I don't want anything. I want you. I want you to calm down. I said, I became born again through you. I followed you through crusades. I saw the Lord heal the sick through you. I saw the deaf hear because through you. I saw the dumb speak through you. I said you must come. Holland is not your place. This was around September. Then he said, you know what? We had a group, the students group, showers of blessing. He said, 10 showers of blessing into a church. I am coming down. He came down. We started fully. Now listen to my story. And that moves me to my fourth point, prayer. The first one is what? Your past. The second one is what? Process. You are going through a process. The third one is prayer. What I didn't know at the time was that everything we were going through was a process. God was building us. God was preparing us. God was teaching us. Like David, God was taking us through the wilderness experience. So now when we get to the throne, we won't joke. Some of you are joking because you haven't been through the process. Some of you do not know how to pay your tithes because you haven't been through the process. Some of you, when we call for offering, you think we are talking about money, my darling, because you haven't gone through the process. Some of you have to be begged before you come to church, my darling, you haven't gone through the process. Some of you leave the church, those people are not here. They leave the church because when they were sick, the pastor didn't visit. The pastor's wife didn't visit. My darling, you haven't gone through the process. You see, you can't clap. My darling, we who have gone through the process, we serve God differently. When you see the pastors who have gone through the process, they are different. And when you see the ones that call themselves prophets, that they don't have a past. They haven't gone through the process. They don't have fathers. They don't have anybody we can see and say that they came through this place. Those people, they are different. My darling, whatever you are going through today, go through it with all joy because it is a process. Bishop, that will say many a day, because I have gone through stuff. I have been poor before. My darling, when you see my hair, and you see my makeup, and you see my nails, and you think that I haven't gone through what you are going through before, you'll be deceiving yourself. I have gone through a period of pain where I didn't know where the next meal was going to come from. I had had my firstborn, and I had had my secondborn for them to go to school. Very neat. I had to go to Bend Down Boutique. You know Bend Down Boutique? go and buy their socks, buy their singlets, come and soak it with Dettol. Buy their school shoes, buy their bag. When I married and things were tough for me, look at me. I had gone to very good schools. I had gone to grade A schools. Yet it got to a time where my certificates didn't matter. I went to the Tuesday market to sell beef. So my husband and I, sister, where are you?
Wash me, body.
Come. How old are you now? Sister is 43. Sister came to me when she was 8 years. Today she's married with 3 boys. What she did to me, her boys are doing worse to her. At a time, my husband, myself, Nanakos, Papa, and sister, we were sleeping in the same room. Process. Is somebody with me? Tell somebody by you, have you gone through the process? Your prayers, those who sow in tears, shall reap in joy. Those who sow in tears, shall reap in joy. While you wait for your season of laughter to come, my darling, Jacob went through the process where he found himself alone. But at the time he found himself alone, he said, God, if you do not bless me, I won't let you go. Whilst you are sitting down waiting, my darling, enter into a period of prayer where you are sowing tears. Anytime you sow your tears, what you are actually doing is that you are sowing prayers. Sow tears of prayer. As you go to the Lord continually in prayers, you will finally reap in joy. So whilst my husband was in Holland, and he had left me with 2 children, and a fifth-hand car. The car will never disgrace me until I see my enemies. That's when it will decide not to go again. Where there's thick traffic on the high street, Accra, he'll tell me, Minko. In that season of mine, I took my annual holiday, which we call in Ghana leave. In those days, I think I had about 28 working days. So when I added the weekends and the holidays and everything, I got about 6 weeks. Bishop, this is what I did within the 6 weeks. Mama Naomi, every morning, I dropped my children in school. Papa in a school called Learning Skills. And then I dropped Nanakos in Morning Star. Once I drop them, I go straight to Achimota Gardens. I think that is why I learned how to remove shoes. I will remove my shoes. In Achimota Gardens, I become like a mad man, a mad woman. And I say, God, when Shramia, God, if you do not bless me, I said, God, if you don't let my husband calm down, I said, God, if you don't do something for me, I said, God, if you don't turn my... I will pray from about 8 p.m., 8 a.m. to about 2 p.m. all by myself. There were no drums. There was no organ. There was no bass guitar. There was nobody leading worship. I will lead my own worship, pray my own prayer, preach to myself, share my own grace, and go and pick my children up. 6 weeks after then, that is when my husband called me and said, I am coming. We started Royal House Chapel with 12 people. 12 grew to 24. 24 grew to 48. 48 grew to 100. 100 grew to 150. 150 grew to 200. 200 grew to 500. And we went on and on and on. It was because a woman sowed tears of prayer.
What's the sound in you? What's the sound in Shebre? Was the Samidi, Edia was three for the Sirimi, Yetimi Pamini, now why am I saying, Iradi, woo, yeah, was the Saminu, now was the Sami Shebre. Was the Sami D? A dia was for the Sirimi. Etimi Pamini. Now why am I saying? Irade. Oh, yeah.
There was a persistent woman who continuously went to a judge. The judge did not fear God and had no regard for God. But this widow wanted justice in a dispute with her enemy. The judge refused and said he won't listen to this woman. But this woman worried and tormented the judge so much that the judge decided to listen to the woman. Then hear what God says. Then the Lord said, hear what the unjust judge said. And shall God not avenge his own elect who cry out day and night to him? Who cry out day and night to him? Who cry out day and night to him? My darling,
who cry out day and night to him. Who cry out day and night to him. Though he bears long with them. My darling, our problem is that we pray today and we expect that God must perform a magic. So we pray this evening. Tomorrow, God must hear us. Listen carefully. Look at me. God knows it. That if you ask him something today, and he does it for you today, you won't be dependent on him. God wants you to pray. He wants you to look up on him. He wants you to depend on him. He wants you to know that you have no one but him. My darling, prayer is not a one-time thing. That is why he says that pray without. My darling, you are in your period of sorrow. You are in your season of crying. You are in your process when everything is difficult. My darling, my third point is prayer. Pray in the morning. Pray at noonday. Pray in the night. Pray when you are driving. Pray when you are having a shower. Pray every least time you get. No prayer of yours goes wasted. The Bible says in Psalm 6, you keep track of all my sorrows. You keep track of all my sorrows. Whatever you are going through, my darling, God is keeping track. Don't ever think that he forgets what you are going through. Don't ever think he doesn't see what you are going through. He keeps track. And the one that I love the most, you have collected all my tears in your bottle. Anytime you come to this altar to pray, every tear you shed, is my English correct? He puts it in a bottle. On your bed, when you pray, he places it in a bottle. When you wake up and you pray, he places it in a bottle. And he says, he has recorded each one of them in a book. My darling, the prayer you prayed last year, during Living Ladies Conference, he has placed it in a bottle. He has recorded it in a book. The one you prayed on 31st December, it hasn't gone waste. Your crying is in the bottle. He has recorded in a book. On Wednesday, when you prayed, he recorded it in a book. Yesterday, he recorded it in a book. Today's prayer, he recorded it. And I am here to let you know that it shall not be long. Thank you.
My days of poverty is over. Somebody didn't hear me. Today, I am allergic to poverty. I have gone through that process. I have gone through that period. My days of selling tolo beef is over. Even my days of working in the bank is over. When I was counting people's money is over. Today, people are counting my money. I have come to prophesy to somebody. That your season is coming. Your season of laughter. Psalm 91 verse 15, reading from the NLT. I'll be closing in a moment. When they call on me, this is God speaking. When they call on me, I will answer. I will be with them in trouble. I will rescue and honor them. When they call on me, I will answer. God is about to answer you. I will be with them in trouble. Whatever you are going through today, I am here to let you know that God is with you. I will rescue and honor you.
I will pray. Oh, I will pray. If I don't pray, Satan will make mess of me. I will pray. Oh, I will pray. If I don't pray, Satan will make mess of me.
I will pray. If I don't pray, Satan will make mess of me.
I will pray. If I don't pray, Satan will make mess of me.
I will pray.
If I don't pray, Satan will make mess of me. I will pray. If I don't pray, Satan will make mess of me. I will pray. If I don't pray, Satan will make mess of me.
I will pray. If I don't pray, Satan will make mess of me.
My darling, I want you to take advantage. You are in this beautiful edifice. Open your mouth and pray. Call upon him.
upon him.
Call upon him. Open your mouth, somebody.
I will pray. If I don't pray, Satan will make mess of me. Close your eyes, sir. The Holy Ghost is here. The power of the Holy Ghost, all over. Angels are moving up. I pay my hand up. Lift up your voice and pray. Warfare tonight by the power of the Holy Ghost. Listen to the name. Ilamakabo Shadadaba. Apani Andakata. Rabo Shadadaba. Ilamasuka Branda. Apelema Andaba. Listen to the name. Lekabanaba. Apelema Andaba Yaba. Rakabanabo Shadadaba.
By the power of the Holy Ghost, the power of the Holy Ghost, all over the place, angels are all over. There is a mover. By the power,
open your mouth, somebody. You are saying, oh God, tonight I need your presence. Tonight I need a touch. Touch me, oh God. Let there be a transformation. Release your power. Release the oil. Release the anointing.
Please be seated. I was looking for somebody. I got a word for her. I can't find her. My darling, when you come to church, always sit down. I can't find her. Somebody wants to take her away from her inheritance. I can't find her. Mama Naomi, that fair colored daughter of yours, she's gone. You know the one I'm talking about. She was following you when we were coming. I don't know her name. Let me see. Yes, it's you. It's over. Your praise. Verse 6, and I'll be done. He who continually goes forth weeping, bearing seed for sowing, shall doubtless come again with rejoicing, bringing his sheep with him. Your seed or your sacrifice is always your worship and is always your praise to God. Your seed, your sacrifice is always your worship and your praise to God. I didn't like the scripture in New King James. Let's look at NIRV, New International Reader's Version. It says, those who go out weeping as they carry seeds to plant will come back singing with joy. They will bring the new crop back with them. NIRV. I don't like it. It is not sweet enough. Let us go to TPT, the Passion Translation. And it reads, they may weep as they go out carrying their seeds to sow. My darling, as you come to the altar with your sacrifice, as you come to the altar with your seed, as you come to the altar with your praise, my darling, you'll be weeping, oh. Sometimes people think you do not know what to do with the money. People think you don't have a need. My darling, this is your period and your season where you are sowing seeds of tears. They may weep as they go out carrying their seed to sow, but they will return with joyful laughter. They will return with joyful laughter. I am concluding. They will return with joyful laughter. They will return with joyful laughter and shouting with gladness as they bring back armloads of blessings and a harvest overflowing. They may weep as they go carrying their seed to sow. Bishop, I have an account. I go into that account maybe every 5 years. My parents opened that account for me when I was born, when I was a baby. When I turned 18, they presented it to me. So I also began to save. And I said to myself, that account, I will never take money from that account until when my children are going to get married. I am a typical Ashanti. Misho Penche. I know that when my children are getting married and I want to do something, my husband, typical gun, will say, hey, yeah. So I keep that account and I call it marriage account. It is for the weddings of my children. I went into that account when Papa was getting married. After then, I began to sow again, to invest again. The money grew. Now, when I started City of Shiloh, I needed money. I needed money so badly. Where's Nixon? That day I went to the bank, I was with him. Bishop, me yisi kanuna mi isu. I'm not joking, oh. I cried, mama. From the bank, Adam Soman, Standard Chart, and now they call it Stan Chart. From there, through the motorway, through Central University, through Chopoli Junction, through City of Shiloh, I was crying. For those of you who do not know City of Shiloh, City of Shiloh is a campground, a place to meet God, a place to have an encounter with God. It's also going to be a place for a rehab center for drug addicts, prostitutes. I already have that school. I've had that school in the last 7 years. And sometimes people call me from all over. I have a son who is on drugs. I want a place to camp. So it's also going to be a place for abused or battered women. Bishop, all my life savings, since I was a baby, since 1962, when my parents opened that account, I took the money. It felt like I had dug a hole and I had poured the money. Listen, church, God is here. I would not lie to you. Since that day that I sowed that seed crying, Bishop, when the money is coming, it comes in dollars, it comes in pounds, it comes in euros. We are live streaming, so there are certain things I can't say. The Lord has blessed me. I was at Shiloh. I came back yesterday night. I went there with Nixon. He hasn't been there for a while. When he got there, he was there with me from the very first day. So as for him, he knows the story of Shiloh. He got to Shiloh. He said, "Mommy, it's the Shiloh. How I have been able to do it, I don't know until now." My darling, listen to me. Don't allow anybody to tell you when you sow in church, it goes into the pocket of a pastor. Don't
don't allow anybody to tell you pastors are trouble. Maybe some pastors are doing it, but not here. Not Royal House Chapel. My darling, people are chopping your money, isn't it? People are chopping your money. Let's talk. Pastors are chopping your money, isn't it? How much? Since you joined Living Faith, calculate how much you have given and ask what you have given. Can he do what we are seeing? I can see the sky, and I can see stars in the sky. You have a pastor who is accountable. Look at the chair. Look at the chair you are sitting on. Even Royal House, we don't have this kind of chair. Our chair, by the time you finish church, your buttocks is hurting. My darling, look at me. You will sow in tears. You will come back with laughter. You will come back with your blessings. And some kind of sowing when you sow, you might not see it today. That seed you sow becomes generational. That is why I know me, as I stand here, nobody can kill me when God is not done with me. That is why I know that the miracles and the testimonies of my children might delay, but it might come. You are sowing in tears. Tomorrow, walking, I will hear your testimony. Let me have some envelopes.
Moving with the speed of the Holy Ghost, I am favored. We are walking in abundance, walking in abundance. Moving with the speed of the Holy Ghost, I am favored. There's an overflow, abundance of blessings. It's a new level, it's a new level. There's an overflow, abundance of favor. We're taking over, we're taking over. There's an overflow, abundance of favor.
You can come, you can sing, but you can come down. They may weep as they go out carrying their seed to sow, but they will return with joyful laughter and shouting with gladness as they bring back armloads, trucks, wheelbarrows, tipper trucks of blessing and a harvest overflowing. If you believe in my sermon, maybe you believed everything, but the praise aspect, you don't believe it. I won't force you, but me, I know what my praise has done. Nehemiah said, God, remember what I have done. There must always be something that you can ask God to look at. 1,000 Ghana cedis.
1,000 Ghana cedis.
Moving with the speed of the Holy Ghost, I am favored. Walking in abundance, moving with the speed of the Holy Ghost, I am favored.
500.
Walking in abundance, moving with the speed of the Holy Ghost, I am favored. We walking in abundance, moving with the speed of the Holy Ghost, I am favored. Walking in abundance, moving with the speed of the Holy Ghost,
Yahweh. Your name is Yahweh.
again. Come and do a miracle, a miracle today. Miracle worker, you are a miracle worker. Oh, come and do a
anything
miracle,
you have.
A miracle today.
This is not about.
Come and do a miracle.
Anything you have.
A miracle today. Your name is Yahweh. Your name is Yahweh. You are a miracle working God. Your name is Yahweh.
Anything you have.
Your name is Yahweh. Your name is Yahweh. You are a miracle working God. Your name is Yahweh.
Anything you have.
Your name is Yahweh.
This is not about money.
Your name is Yah. Oh, your name is Yahweh. Your name is Yahweh. You're a miracle working God. Your name is Yah. Your name is Yahweh. Yahweh. Your name is Yahweh. You're a miracle working God. Your name.
Anything you have.
Miracle worker. You are a miracle worker. Hey, come and do a miracle today. Come and do a miracle today. Destiny changer, destiny changer. You are a destiny changer. Oh.
Place your right hand on your heart and say, this is my period of laughter. Say, this is my season of laughter. I can hear you. This is my season of laughter. I will laugh. I will go through the process. My season of poverty, my season of sickness, my season of lack, my season of crying will be over, and I will enter into my season of laughter. In the name of Jesus. Let my seed today, my seed of tears, let it bring me laughter. Let it bring me armloads of miracles. Let it bring me testimonies. I will stand in front here. I would hold the microphone and I will share my story of what God has done for me. God bless you, and I love you.
What do we say to our mommy? Please rise up and give Mama Rita a mighty clap offering. A mighty round of applause for what the Lord has used him to do in our midst. What amazing, powerful message. This is a relatable message. It relates to you. I mean, the story is amazing, and you can tell that God is not a respecter of persons. When you work in the house of the Lord, and when God sees, God will reward you in due season. Hallelujah. Please, can you take
our guest to the purple room, please. Take Mama Rita, let her go and rest. She's tired. Please take our guest to the purple room. Mrs. Honorable Mama Carol Rosemont, please. Jennifer, please take them outside. Take them to the purple room. We thank the Lord. Even though time is fast spent, we have benefited from what the Lord has given to us. Amen. Listen, when we used to go to discos, we don't care. We stay there till 12 a.m., 1 a.m., and we still party. Sometimes you go to parties and you don't care. This is the house of the Lord. We came to hear of God's word, and it has been a blessing for you to be here. Tell your neighbor, I know God has blessed you tonight, and you are not going to be the same again. God has blessed you tonight. It's not going to be the same. Hallelujah. Please, let's raise our hands up. Tomorrow, God's willing, if the rapture doesn't come, 11 a.m., we have amazing breakfast and lunch. We call it brunch. We have worked enough. Give a mighty clap of hands to Jesus. We are going to sit down and enjoy. And in our enjoyment, we are going to hear something, mental wellness. Why we are doing certain things that we are not supposed to do. Sometimes in church, some behaviors that you see people in and you wonder, why should a believer, a child of God, do certain things? Please come in your numbers. Call your friend, call your name. We have food in abundance. 11 a.m. Come. And it's 11 to 1. Come and have fun and see and hear the glory of God from our own woman of God, Dr. Debbie. Hallelujah. Give her a clap offering. She's going to really give to us. So come in your... No, don't stay home. And God will be... What happened?
Look at me and listen to me, everyone. It doesn't matter the amount of money you gave. It will speak for you. Me, my miracle service is the seed you have given.
Tell them your story.
Short. Yes. 99. I'm about to get married. Then I have this accident. I was shattered, frustrated. Mommy came to Togo and come and preach. Why I remember your face now, you are saying your husband is there, your mentor, your spiritual father, the same thing you mentioned that day. I come and sow a seed that I cry that if I marry God, because I'm alone in the family, give me a sisters. This is your seed. Pastor Drass Church, 99. Wow.
I release the blessing of the Lord over you. Your mother's sacrifice for you. Out of that sacrifice, you came forth. Every delay in your life, I cancel. You will never struggle in life. Because a mother sacrificed on the altar for you. Out of her tears will be your greatness. Out of her tears will be your marriage. Out of her tears will be your success. You will also sacrifice for your future children. May you be blessed as a family. May you be protected. May the Lord place laughter in your mouth. In the name of Jesus. Amen. My darling, if I collected your money to go and chop, 99, they won't come to give a testimony.
May your sacrifice speak for you. You also have something.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. This testimony I've already told, ma'am.
And she says she's been looking for me for a long time. You are home.
Praise the Lord. I'm going to give this testimony to encourage all of us. I have been blessed by Mami Rita and her husband, our own daddy, Sam Krunchy Ankrah. Once upon a time, I was in Life International Church. You came there, we're under a canopy, and we're supposed to build a containerized office for the pastor. I remember they had never dashed me money before. I was building my house in the village. I had gone for loan and I tied on the loan. And I told God to build a house for me. They called me, they said they needed 200 million, that's 20,000. And nobody had ever given me 5,000 before. I was a minister then. I sat in my car and I said, God, please, move me, check me, 20,000. My driver and bodyguard, they laugh at me because of a funny prayer. 3 days after, somebody came and actually gave me that money because I said I was going to do concrete. But hold on. I needed 20,000. God gave me 20,000. And I paid tight 2,000. That's 20 million. So it was short because it was a budget that was given to me by the tailor. I kept it in my account. Then we went to church. Then was Mami Rita and Daddy. They were the guest speakers. He says we should contribute to the office. The only money I had was the 18,180. I took my check and I wrote 30,003,000. Knelt down and sent it. The man of God stood there and said, you have more than that in your account. Somebody is seated here. You have more than that in your account. If you have brought something that you know you have more than that, come and add. I sat down and I wrote a check for 10,000. So I went down on my knees. Then I said, God, I asked you for 20,000. You gave me. And I've given you 2,000 as my tithe. I have come back. Now he says I should bring more. So I'm going to give you 10,000. So I'll be left with only 80 million. You know he cannot do the work. I said, Father, I'm going to put it in the account. Now you come and add so that I can go and do my work. Thank you for doing it. And I got up. And I sent the check to our own daddy, Sam Krunchy Ankrah. And I told him I was coming to now change. So he gave me the 3,001 and took the 10,000. And he prayed and blessed me. Mommy, tell daddy that that house, the same person who gave me the 20,000, it was a Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, he called me and said, Honorable, it was in the night. I want to come and know where you live. I said, okay, come. He came. He said, look, I've not been to school, but I have a lot of money. I just want to be close to people like you. I said, no problem. He asked me, your house, have you tiled? As a matter of fact, I needed the money for tiling. So I said, no. He called a company and said, tomorrow, Honorable Hanabisu is coming. Whatever she needs, give it to her. If at that time, I didn't know I could use tiles for my yard as Daddy has done here. He said, go to Energy Commission. Go and look at their parking lot. It's tiles. I want you to do that. 4 articulator loads of things. Everything I needed. Not just that. I entered the shop. I was looking at heaters. I didn't know the man. He said, how many do you want? I said, I don't have money. I'm just looking. He said, no, how many do you want? I said, I will need 6. He called his guy, said, bring us 6 heaters. To the glory of God, he dashed me those 6 heaters. The air conditions in my house were dashed to me. I prepared the house for louvers. I had to change the space because somebody came and did sliding windows for me for free. The beds, mommy, and the wardrobes, the quality, They were charging me 20,000, only paid 5,000. They carried all their materials from Accra, went and built in all the 6 rooms. When they finished, they told me for free. I could not buy cement. I was in Sunyan. Across the street, somebody ran and came and told my bodyguard, I want to talk to this woman, I like her.
Before she finishes, if you yourself, between you and God, the money you gave is too small, come and add.
Praise the Lord. I'm cutting because I want you all to know that sometimes when we do things, I'm a testimony of their ministry. The young man ran across the road. When I came, he said, Honorable, I like you so much. But I was wondering from a distance, how did he see me? I said, okay, how are you? Then I realized his car, they said, Gassem. I needed cement, I couldn't afford. So I said, I also need something from you. I want cement, but I cannot buy even the wholesale, like pay for wholesale. I cannot pay for retail. I want it on loan. He told me, give me a number and a name and consider it done. Today, I do not know where that man is. My brothers and sisters, I finished building that house and people were out there saying, I built a mansion. I told God to deal with each one of them who is trying to steal his glory, because that house was built on tithe, that house was built on offering, that house was built on obedience. Sacrifices. I did so in tears. I didn't have. He gave me. I gave it back to him and he overly blessed me. This to the glory of God. Mommy, thank you so much and thank Daddy for me. This is my testimony to the glory of God.
My goodness. We thank the Lord. We thank the Lord. What do we say to God? Father, we thank you. Let this testimony encourage you. Sometimes giving in church is like pulling hair from your nose. But as she said, those who sow in tears reaps in joy. The Lord shall meet you at the point of your need. As you are coming to give or as you are giving, one thing I just pick from their messages. Give from your heart. Don't come grieving. Don't come murmuring. Give from your heart. Because the Lord that sees our inward hearts is him that is going to reward you. When she gave, it wasn't Mama Rita or Apostle General that rewarded her. It was God that rewarded them. So in everything you are doing in the house, do it from your heart. And the Lord that sees shall reward you. Amen. Please lift up your hands.
Yedawasi Eradinya Kupon Yedawasi Yada wase sera ko.
What shall we render unto you, Jehovah? We thank you for such an awesome word, message given to your children. Anytime we come before you, you never leave us unattended. We thank you for such a powerful and awesome, glorious message that you have given to us through your woman's servant. What shall we render? What shall we render? What shall we give in exchange for your power, for your glory, for your deliverances, for your encouragement, for your comfort? We just want to say thank you for all you do for us. Father, we can't thank you enough. So from the hearts of your people, from the hearts of your handmaids, from the hearts of your men standing before you, we want to say thank you. Take the glory. And when everything is done, your name alone is worthy to be exalted. I lift up our mommy into your hands. From the hearts that she poured out, we ask for rejuvenation. We ask for refilling. We ask for continuous glory and more of your glory over her life. More of your beauty over her life. More of your, oh my God, whatever needed for her life to be completed so she can pour more to her people. May it be granted. May you continue to show her favor. May you continue to beautify her life. May you continue to cause her to glow. May you continue to cause her to expand. May you continue to cause her to extend her eyes to the poor, that us men shall know that there is a God in heaven. I lift up our papa as well into your hands. I commit each of everyone in this house, those that came by walking, those that came driving, those that came riding, I pray that you take us safely to our destination. Father, we ask for your strength. We ask for your protection. Angelic to be dispatched for our sake, that as we get to our houses and our destination safely, we shall with one accord give you the glory. And as we meet here tomorrow again at 11 a.m. to 1 p.m., we shall say the Lord is good and his mercy is endured forever. Please lift up your hands and raise your voice and let's share the grace together. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forever. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Hallelujah. We thank everyone for coming tomorrow. The word of God is there to bless you. We are here for a token and for a treat. The Lord do you good. See you tomorrow. We thank you so much. God take you home safely. Sunday morning, 9 a.m.
By the wonderful sermon share to us and ask the saints that are joining me here.
been a very wonderful service. It's been a wonderful time with a preacher who has impacted us with so much word of God. And joining me here is my beautiful honorable, who will be joining us shortly. And I know surely you've been filled with so much blessing. Thank you, mommy. How are you doing, please?
I'm blessed.
And you are looking so amazing.
Thank you.
All right, so how has today's service been?
A blessing. Wow. I mean, for me, the 3 days have been a blessing. I have been blessed. I'm excited. I remember I was in Asino. I have to, when we finish, I have to leave the place 11:30 p.m. to get here at dawn, because I didn't want to miss a single day. And it's been joy. Daddy's messages were excellent. Today, Mommy Rita Korankye Ankrah has blessed us. Reverend, she has blessed. I mean, I don't know what to do. So, for me, the Lord has settled.
All right, thank you very much, mommy. Thank
and
you.
And I'll tell any other woman out there that next time that you hear Living Ladies Conference, please run and come so that I can also get your blessing.
Amen. Shalom. Amen. 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 Wherever you are, wherever you join us around the world, tomorrow do all to join us here at Living Faith Ministry International. We are located in Ashaley, Botwe, Pentecost Down. Do not miss this service. Do not miss this service. So we'll still be speaking to some of our leaders so they share their experience. This is the third day of the Living Ladies Conference. And do not exempt yourself. Join us here tomorrow. So I have my beautiful lady joining me right now. How are you doing?
I'm very fine, yourself.
And how has the sermon been?
Oh, it has been very, very powerful and productive.
All right, so is there anything you are actually taking home with?
Sure. Mama Rita has been very, very productive. And about the giving aspect, now I'm going to give very, very well. I'm going to give.
So we are not going to put the money in our purses this time around.
No. There is blessing in giving.
And I hope you are also going to invite a friend.
Sure.
To come
sure.
with you probably
yes,
tomorrow.
Yes, I will.
All right. So thank you very much for spending time with us. God bless you. Amen. All right. So as she said, she will be given. Giving comes with a lot of blessings. That those who sow in sorrow surely weep abundantly in joy. So I have here with me a sister, Living Ladies,
raising the standard.
So how has the sermon been so far?
It was great. I was so blessed tonight. I was so touched. I was inspired tonight. I was really, really inspired. And then I'm believing that the word that I heard tonight is going to inspire me. It's going to help me to walk through the process and then to wait for my time. Yeah.
All right. So that's been an amazing time. God bless you and thank you for joining us. All right. So we have our mommy here. Mommy, good evening.
Good evening.
Oh, come please join me here. How are you doing, please?
I'm fine.
And you are looking so amazing.
Yes, I'm so happy.
Oh wow. So if you can probably share with us how the sermon has been.
Oh, the sermon is very wonderful, and I'm coming from Togo because of the program.
Wow.
I came in on Wednesday, so I'll be here yesterday, Thursday, today, Friday. I'll be here tomorrow, Saturday, Sunday, then Monday I'll go back to Togo.
Oh, then can you give us some aware, just say some. Oh mommy, please come closer. Uh-huh. So I'm sure the OS would want to hear you speak.
Yeah.
What are the things you're actually taking home with what Mama Rita spoke about? So if you can probably speak that in OS for us.
Okay, Mama Rita, gblonami egbebe, ki weda, fesa mia pre egbedodora, eyenye nuse, mia so mia pa mia pa gbedodora le mia ba kulo jine mi pa gbedodora mia ngenu kule jijo the yes ben come. Amen.
Amen. I think what I heard was pray. Right? Yes. So pray without season.
Yes.
My beautiful ladies out there, pray without seasons. And then you can also speak some French.
Oui,
all right.
Oui.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Notre maman dit aujourd'hui, on doit prier. On doit prier sans saison. Avec prier sans saison là, on va récolter tout ce que on veut dans au nom de Jésus.
Oui, madame. So it's been an amazing time. Thank you very much, all those who are watching straight from YouTube to Facebook. Do not miss tomorrow's service. Do all to join us each and every time. And God bless you for being with us throughout the entire service. Have a wonderful evening. Thank you.